Welcome to Module 6 of the What Works Clearinghouse WWC Group Design Standards Training. You can access all of the resources mentioned in this module through the WWC's website, whatworks.ed.gov. This module focuses on the third step in the process of reviewing findings from randomized group designs, namely assessing compositional change. In this module, we will explain why the WWC is concerned about compositional change in randomized controlled trials, or RCTs. We will summarize how compositional change can affect the research ratings of RCTs. We then will describe how to assess compositional change in RCTs. The third step in the group design study review process involves assessing any changes to the composition of the intervention and comparison groups after units have been randomly assigned to conditions. The reason the WWC assesses compositional change when reviewing RCTs is that any change to the composition of the intervention and comparison groups after random assignment can introduce bias into intervention impact estimates. In other words, compositional changes mean that the randomized design may no longer account for differences in observable and unobservable characteristics of the groups, although compositional change also can occur in quasi-experimental designs, or QEDs, the WWC does not assess compositional changes in QEDs. This is because the WWC already assumes that QEDs cannot fully account for differences in observable and unobservable group characteristics. When reviewing a QED study, WWC reviewers should skip this step on compositional change and proceed to the fourth step in the review process, where they will assess whether the study authors satisfied the baseline equivalence standard, which is described in the next module of this training series. In individual-level RCTs, compositional change occurs through sample attrition. Attrition refers to instances where units that were assigned to intervention or comparison conditions leave the study or are otherwise unavailable for outcome measurement. In cluster-level RCTs, where clusters or groups of intact units randomly are assigned to conditions, the WWC considers three types of compositional change: cluster-level attrition, individual-level attrition, and joiners. We will provide greater detail on these types of compositional change in the remainder of this module. The WWC's assessment of compositional change plays an important role in a study's research rating. Findings from RCTs are eligible to receive the highest possible research rating, meets WWC standards without reservations, if it is an individual-level RCT with low attrition or a cluster-level RCT with a low risk of bias due to compositional change. A cluster-level RCT is deemed to have a low risk of bias due to compositional change if it has low cluster-level attrition, low individual-level attrition, and the analyses exclude high-risk joiners. In contrast, individual-level RCTs with high sample attrition or cluster RCTs with high cluster-level attrition, high individual-level attrition, or those that include high-risk joiners in the analyses cannot receive the highest research rating. Rather, in these scenarios, the WWC assumes there is a high risk of bias due to compositional change, so the highest possible research rating is meets WWC standards with reservations. We now will turn to an in-depth discussion of how the WWC assesses these types of compositional changes, which vary depending on the level of assignment in the research design.